கவிதையின் பேர் நான் பறந்து கொண்டே இருப்பேன். கவிதையின் பேர் என்ன? நான் பிறந்தேன் அரும்பெரும் சக்தியுடன். நான் பிறந்தேன் நற்பண்புகளுடன். நான் பிறந்தேன் கனவுடன். வளர்ந்தேன் நல்ல எண்ணங்களுடன். நான் பிறந்தேன் உயர் எண்ணங்களை செயல்படுத்த. நான் பிறந்தேன் ஆராய்ச்சி உள்ளத்துடன். நான் பிறந்தேன் ஆகாய உச்சியில் பறக்க. நான் பூமியில் ஒருபோதும் தவழ மாட்டேன். தவழவே மாட்டேன். ஆகாய உச்சிதான் என் லட்சியம். பறப்பேன் வாழ்வில் பறந்து கொண்டே இருப்பேன்.
India recorded its first flight in 1932. Since then, it has made its mark in the aerospace and defense industries. The country's journey into aerospace manufacturing began in 1940 when state-run Hindustan Aeronautics Limited was set up. India now has a vibrant private sector aerospace industry, from large conglomerates like the Tata Group to hundreds of micro, small and medium-sized enterprises. Recently, a Tamil Nadu MSME Aerospace Engineers Private Limited bagged a deal with the world's largest aerospace firm, Boeing, to manufacture and supply critical aviation components. But the Salem-based Aerospace Engineers Private Limited's journey from a Tier 2 supplier to Tier 1 supplier was not always smooth. It faced many turbulent situations before finally landing the Boeing deal.
Particular about Boeing, I started making the Boeing part 17 years back. So that was the replacement market, that is called MRO, maintenance repair overall. So we started working with Boeing. First part I developed for Boeing is Boeing 747, one small bellow. So first I saw the Boeing drawing and started working with the Boeing drawings with some trading companies. Then second, we entered into Tier 2 for Boeing parts. We had to work for Boeing part, and we had to supply, not directly Boeing, through some integrator agency. We are supplying our products, then Boeing will consume our products. That is stage 2. Now stage 3, directly getting the order from direct on us, Boeing direct supplier. It is really great journey. And there is a great opportunity available for our Indian entrepreneurs. Those who are interested to enter into aerospace and defense, they can enter. It's a right time for us, and it's a great opportunity also. When I created this industry in 1988, in the initial days, I concentrated only on import substitution sell and indigenous development. But nowadays, with our Prime Minister's Make in India policy, and Atmanirbhar, and our Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu created the Make in Tamil Nadu. These are all giving a good thrust for our Indian SMEs, Tamil Nadu SMEs also. And now the Government of India, they stopped importing the value less than 200 crores. We cannot, any PSUs or EDRDO cannot import. So that much of thrust is having, sir. So those who are having the capability of making the requirement, certainly we can secure the orders from DRDO or DPSUs, etc. Government of India, they are creating the Tamil Nadu Aero Cluster, Aerospace and Defense Cluster. So they need 1,000 industries, sir. 1,000 new or old industries should come for defense corridor, Tamil Nadu defense corridor. That much of opportunities available. I am requesting the young entrepreneurs, you enter into aerospace and defense and you can develop so many components for aerospace and defense areas. So opportunities are available, sir. Presently, we are planning to have the orders requirement of 2,500 part numbers from Boeing. But certainly, we can enhance to some more quantity also, some more part numbers also. As long as we are giving good product, good delivery, good pricing, certainly we can earn the goodwill of Boeing and we can get more and more orders from Boeing. And apart from this, as a company, my company, I'm planning to create a small aircraft. That's my ambition. Smaller aircraft like 10-seater and 12-seater aircraft. In India, we have to build the aircraft.
Vinod for the Federal from Salem.